Hi, let's talk about the superficial features of the heart. In this video, we'll discuss the external features of the heart, including the chambers of the heart that are associated with various surfaces and borders of the heart. Recall that the heart is a four-chambered organ. There are two atria, a right atrium and a left atrium, that are separated by an interatrial septum. There are two ventricles, a right ventricle and a left ventricle, which are separated by an interventricular septum. And then the atria and the ventricles are separated by atrioventricular valves, which are surrounded by dense connective tissue that really forms the fibrous skeleton of the heart. And sometimes we refer to this as the atrioventricular septum. There are also semilunar valves. Aortic here is demonstrated, but there's also a pulmonary valve that are part of this fibrous skeleton that are anchored in there. So as we look to the surface of the heart, we'll see a few sulci and appendages that are associated with these deeper structures. The first and probably largest is that of the coronary sulcus. The coronary sulcus can be seen here. Let me draw this in. There and there. That's going to be in line with that fibrous skeleton or the atrioventricular septum. Sometimes it's called the atrioventricular sulcus, but anything above this will be atrium. So that's right atrium. That's left atrium. And anything below this will be ventricle. So that's right ventricle and left ventricle. There's also anterior and posterior interventricular sulci. This is the anterior sulcus. And that's going to be superficial to the interventricular septum. So that allows us to differentiate right from left ventricle there. And then finally, while we're here, there are auricles of the atria. Auricle just means ear, and these are extensions of the atria. They allow for a little extra blood to accumulate within the atria. Within the lining of these would be very rigid pectinate muscles, as we'll see. If we look at the posterior and inferior portion of the heart, we can see a continuation of that coronary sulcus there, as well as there. We can also see the posterior interventricular sulcus, which is aligning with the interventricular septum. So we can see that there are atria above the coronary, so that would be the left atrium. Over here would be the right atrium, and we have the left ventricle and right ventricle. You might also notice that within these sulci, various elements of vasculature can be found. So the main brunts of the coronary arteries and the coronary sinus can be found within the coronary sulcus. So they make for a really excellent opportunity for vasculature to move through. Let's turn our attention to just the surfaces of the heart. Let's think of the heart as a three-dimensional organ, because it is, and it deserves to be thought of that way. And we can identify several cardiac surfaces. First of all, there is an anterior, also known as the sternocostal surface, because it would be deep to the sternum and the ribs. And we can see that colored in here as yellow. We have a right surface, which is colored here as purple. We really don't have a fantastic view of the right surface. We would need a right lateral view to fully appreciate that. There is a left surface, also known as the pulmonary surface. And we can get a very nice view here of the left surface of the heart. Then there is a base of the heart. The base of the heart is everything that would be oriented posteriorly. And then finally, a diaphragmatic surface. The diaphragmatic surface is the portion of the heart which would rest, you know, in the same virtual plane as the diaphragm. It's sloping sort of anteroinferiorly and towards the left, because that's the direction of the apex of the heart, as we'll see. There are several heart borders also associated with various chambers. So we have a superior border here, which is in association with both right and left atria. The left atrium is going to be deep. It's not contained there, but it will be deep to where that mark is. We have a right border here in purple. That's associated with the right atrium. We have a left border here in blue, also known as the obtuse margin of the heart. That left border is in association with the left atrium as well as the left ventricle, but it's predominantly associated with the left ventricle. There's also an inferior border in green here. That inferior border is predominantly associated with the right ventricle, but it's also in part associated with the left ventricle. And then we have the apex of the heart. The apex of the heart is generally in association with that interventricular septum, sometimes including a little bit of each ventricle, depending on how you want to conceptualize that. Now, these borders are going to be very helpful in discussing imaging. So for instance, I've included two radiographs here. I'm not going into any detail, but you can see how things like that right border and inferior border and left border and superior border can be important when discussing differences among images of the heart within the pericardium. So we've discussed the various sulci and appendages and how they relate to deeper septa and structure. We've also discussed the various surfaces of the heart and the various borders of the heart and how they relate to different chambers. This is your summary slide. Thank you for your time.